To kickstart the review of an Honor phone by making a mention of Xiaomi might feel like doing injustice to Honor. Having said that, such is the clout of Xiaomi. While both these brands are from the Chinese subcontinent, Xiaomi has grown from strength to strength in India. Honor's growth has also been phenomenal, and one cannot deny that, but the scale is nowhere close to Xiaomi's at the moment. To fix that situation, Honor has been actually making quality budget phones in 2018. The latest from Honor in an attempt to put a dent in Xiaomi's sales is the Honor 9N. The Honor 9N is a starkly different phone when compared to the Redmi series. It emphasizes form over sheer power, and that is not necessarily a bad thing. Hi, I'm Ashar from Mr. Phone, and here's my full review of the newly launched Honor 9N. So before we move on, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it to get notified about awesome Mr. Phone tech content. Also, we've started a community on WhatsApp and Facebook, links to which should be in the description below. The Honor 9N is an undoubtedly gorgeous phone. In fact, if you ask me, I think it is the best looking phone in this price segment. But that's a subjective thing, so I'll let you guys decide that for yourself. The 9N's design is very similar to the 9 Lite. But the front is where everything changes. The 9N is one of the very few phones to come with a notch in under Rs 15,000. This gives the 5.84-inch display more screen estate and it looks attractive. Now obviously, I'm not a fan of the notch, but it makes more sense in budget phones. Why? Because the R&D money to eliminate the notch will probably be used for flagship phones first. Until then, the notch is the best possible way to reduce screen estate. The phone is made of glass on the front and the back and has plastic running along the sides. It is a good looking design, no doubt, and the new colors, robin egg blue and lavender purple, look extremely attractive. Like I mentioned in my first impressions of the phone, I would urge you to wait for one of these colors because you will stand out when you use this phone. Also, Honor bundles a good hard plastic case inside the box as well. The fingerprint scanner sits on the rear and it is easy to reach and it works fast as well. But there's also face unlock and it works well, but it is not very fast. It mostly failed to recognize my face in the dark. All things considered, the Honor 9N still has two minor design inconveniences according to me. One of which is the fact that you still get a micro USB port at the bottom, and the volume rocker and the power button are slightly flush with the sides. Therefore, the tactile feedback is not that great. The 5.84-inch display on the front uses IPS LCD tech. It offers a resolution of 2280 by 1080 pixels, which is Full HD+. It is a crisp and bright panel that will satisfy any user. The maximum brightness levels and the lowest brightness settings are very good. If you ask me honestly, I prefer the IPS LCD panel on the Honor 9N compared to the Redmi Note 5 Pro. The viewing angles are great and so is the sunlight legibility. To top it off, the software gives you the option to turn off the notch. And the software engineers at Honor have done an excellent job at hiding the notch by maintaining symmetry as well. For someone like me who has an OCD for such kind of things, the Honor 9N doesn't trigger it. Seriously, good job Honor. The Honor 9N runs on Huawei's homegrown Emotion UI, or EMUI as you know it. The EMUI skin is based on Android Oreo and it supports Project Treble as well, which means that future Android updates like Android P can be implemented faster on the phone. EMUI has actually evolved beautifully over the years, so much so that it is one of my favorite skins on an Android smartphone. I've spoken about it in length in my review of the Honor 9 Lite, and you know, Shree has also spoken about it at length in the Honor 10 and the Honor View 10 review, links to which should be here somewhere in a card. You can take a look at those reviews because most of my observations remain the same until a new update comes about with more additional features. The Honor 9N has the same dual camera setup on the rear like the Honor 9 Lite. You get a 13 megapixel primary sensor and a 2 megapixel depth sensor. On the front, you now get a 16 megapixel shooter instead of a dual camera unit. But let it be known that Honor is using pixel binning to increase the pixel size 2 microns from 1 micron size. This should ideally mean better details in selfies. In fact, I recently did a detailed camera comparison with the Redmi Note 5 Pro. A link should be in a card somewhere. And found the Honor 9N to be lacking slightly. Here are a few takeaways from that comparison that I did. One, the camera app is very well laid out, but a small detail like going through multiple steps to invoke the portrait mode was annoying. Also, the portrait shots are not as good as the Redmi Note 5 Pro. You don't get as many details and the cutout is not very accurate either. The selfies, while detailed, resort to a lot of artificial sharpening. Or maybe that's how pixel binning works. 4. Daylight shots and HDR captures look good on the Honor 9N. 5. The Honor 9N tends to shoot up exposure slightly for most shots, and the saturation is also on the higher end. 6. The video recording through the front camera is great, but using the rear camera, not so much. 7. There are some really great modes like the night mode, which uses, you know, slow shutter to actually capture more light. And the AR stickers function are really cool too. The Honor 9N continues to use the dated 659 processor. However, there is so much in store for the phone. For example, a GPU Turbo update is coming soon, which means gaming performance should be slightly more optimized. In its current state though, the phone is as powerful as all the other Kirin 659 phones I've used in the past. No doubt, the Kirin 659 doesn't offer raw power like the Snapdragon 636, but makes up for it with reliable performance. I managed to play PUBG at medium settings with a little bit of lag and no signs of heating up at all. And in daily usage, the phone works smoothly most of the times. That is, until you use the default SwiftKey keyboard. The keyboard is so heavy-handed that it feels like I'm using a phone from 2015. I'd strongly suggest replacing it with Gboard for better experience. As for the speaker, the single downward firing speaker is average at best. And the sound quality through the 3.5mm jack is good, but I've experienced better. However, when it comes to sound through the earpiece, the Honor 9N's call quality is unbeatable. You get a crystal clear sound with great noise cancellation in calls. Honestly, Huawei's networking chops are clearly at play here. The Honor 9N's 3000mAh battery is actually a bit of a letdown. I got around 4 hours of screen on time on heavy usage, but with phones like the Zenfone Max Pro M1 existing at the same price range, the Honor could have been better in my opinion. So that brings us to the end of the review, where I answer the question, should you buy the Honor 9N? In my opinion, the Honor 9N is a unique smartphone that looks attractive and is intriguing from the moment you lay your eyes on it. But like many other phones in this price range, the Honor 9N is not without any flaws. Especially the camera performance, I think, could have been better, but it makes up for it by adding a lot of shooting modes. Having said that, the Honor 9N is definitely in my top 3 smartphones under Rs. 15,000. Overall, I think that the Honor 9N is perfect for the rebels and the misfits. If you're someone who doesn't like conforming to norms, the Honor 9N might be the perfect flaunt-worthy device for you. And if you crave for power, you have phones like the Redmi Note 5 Pro, the Zenfone Max Pro M1, and the Realme 1 at your disposal. That was my review of the Honor 9N. Do let us know in the comment section below what you thought about it. Until next time, this is Aishat signing off. Goodbye.